At FINRA, our mission is investor protection and market integrity. In this Day Inside FINRA series, we show you how FINRA employees carry out our mission. Here, we head to Rockville, Maryland, where we meet FINRA Senior Security Engineer, Dan.
Bye-bye, Daddy.
Welcome to Ashburn, Virginia. I'm Dan. Please join me at my day at FINRA.
This morning, I woke up at 6:30, got ready and left around 7 o'clock. Got on the Beltway, loved that traffic. Came into the office around 8:15. I quickly sit at my desk, check the email, grab a cup of tea, head down, grab a breakfast, definitely catch up on the news, head back up to the office, then quickly review any submissions that might have occurred overnight.
Dan works in FINRA's cybersecurity team, monitoring for potential breaches that could compromise confidential information with the possibility to harm FINRA and ultimately investors.
My role is to keep FINRA's workstation safe. The most obvious route for malware and anything malicious to come into the enterprise is with users, most commonly through email. I do get those submissions from FINRA employees, and we also have systems set up to automatically send us alerts. The most common malware that we have received on a day-to-day basis has been ransomware. The ransomware, it'll masquerade as an Office document or an Excel spreadsheet trying to entice the user to open it. At that point, it'll encrypt the workstation. You either pay the ransom or need to get your workstation re-imaged.
Data security is a never-ending concern at FINRA. Dan and his team are responsible for making sure hackers or viruses do not compromise any confidential information.
I take the malware challenge personally. I am definitely a workaholic. If I'm at home, you know, I'm firing up the workstation. I'm getting alerts on my phone. I'm always researching either the latest attack methodologies. I'm just wanting to keep FINRA safe. Late last year, the strange program tripped one of the alerts that we already set up. Still remember, it was called Lola. Did a little digging, researched onto the workstation, did see that it was making web calls and trying to pull down, you know, additional files. We actually validated that it wasn't malicious, but we still had the workstation reimaged. The most important thing about my job is persistence and dedication. So always staying connected, always on the lookout for anything potentially malicious that might impact our users and the greater investing public.
Around noon, Dan and a few colleagues often gather for lunch.
Usually for lunch, myself and several team members head down to the cafeteria, sit down, collaborate on projects that are either upcoming or past, and just talk about daily life. Just catch up, talk about sports. Personally, I'm a Cincinnati Bengals fan, so anything Bengals or Cincinnati Reds is definitely right up my alley. After lunch, I come back and check the abuse mailbox, and through the day I'm periodically checking. Then I'm also sitting in several tools, Splunk, which is our log collector, and then also our advanced threat detection tools. It's always a new adventure, you know, checking, you know, the abuse mailbox. There's something new and exciting in there. I know it's, you know, kind of odd to be excited about that, but, you know, it's always, you know, another chance to improve our defenses.
Dan works closely with a team of cybersecurity experts who provide continual monitoring and immediate response in the event of a crisis.
I would say we are the hunt team. We're just lurking around in various tools and dashboards, just looking for anything suspicious or malicious. It's just not an individual effort. We all support each other, back up each other. We're a real informal group. We just have ad hoc meetings. Usually we just send each other's cubes and brainstorm ideas on how we can better protect FINRA. When we do find hack tools or backdoor Trojans, at first, you know, it's a huge adrenaline rush. You're like, oh, wow, you know, I just found this, you know, incredibly terrible thing on a workstation. We're playing, you know, cat and mouse.
Dan sees a tight connection between his job protecting FINRA from data breaches and FINRA's mission of investor protection.
Prior to coming to FINRA, I worked as a desktop support technician at a university and then left to go work for a government contractor. In both of those roles, I was heavily involved in user interaction.
What brought me to FINRA was I wanted to grow in the cybersecurity field.
What spoke to me was FINRA's mission. Again, you know, as an investor myself, you know, I definitely understand and want, you know, to be protected. Everyone has investments, and I guess it's just a great mission to, you know, make sure that the investing public is safe. So by doing our day-to-day jobs, we can protect ourselves and at the same time keep the information of the public protected as well. Definitely do not want a data breach to occur and then harm FINRA and, in the same process, harm the investing public.
All in all, it makes for a busy day for Dan. It's time to get ready to head out, but his work will continue when he gets home to Ashburn.
Later in the day, we begin to start packing up and then begin the commute home. Thank you for visiting me at FINRA's Rockville campus. I hope you learned more about our cybersecurity team. Well, I'm off to go see the wife and kids. Have a good night.
With that, Dan heads off on his drive home to see his family. This evening, he'll check in a few times to keep watch over FINRA. Tomorrow, he'll be back first thing protecting FINRA and investors from cyber threats.